said, "Take your hands off me, you son of a bitch." And he died in front of the altar of God, and his priestly vestments, he died cursing a brother Jesuit and fellow companion of Jesus. So, Jesuits. I would like to read to you itong sinulat na nabasa ko sa internet. Okay. So, parang mabasa. Okay, so, well, yan yung nabasa ko sa internet. During the presidency of Aram, President Aram, you're familiar with him, he wanted to disprove to people that he was voted mainly because of his popularity. So he got the chance of his life when one day, Pag-asa announced that there would be a spectacular solar eclipse at 9 o'clock in the morning of the following day. President Aram called up various experts on the solar eclipse in order to learn about this phenomenon. And then, after several lectures that he had received, he wrote this memorandum. So, ito yung memorandum niya. "To all the employees of Malacañang, tomorrow morning, there will be a solar eclipse at 9 o'clock. This is something which we cannot see happening every day. By the power vested upon me, I order all the employees of Malacañang to line up at the palace grounds in their best clothes to watch it. I will personally explain the phenomenon to them. If it rains, everyone must assemble in the canteen where I shall give my lecture about the eclipse." Yan. Yun yung sinulat niyang memorandum. A note to him, one of the daily newspapers got hold of the memorandum and published it this way: "By order of the President, there will be a solar eclipse at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, which the President will explain. If it is raining, the employees of Malacañang will not be able to see it in their best clothes. In that case, the disappearance of the sun will be followed through in the canteen. This is something they cannot see happening every day." Another newspaper that hold of the memorandum and published it this way: "By order of the President, the employees of Malacañang shall follow the disappearance of the sun in their best clothes in the canteen at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. The President will tell them whether it is going to rain. This is something they couldn't see happening every day." Okay, another newspaper, ganito naman ang version niya: If there is a solar eclipse tomorrow morning, something that the employees of Malacañang cannot see happening every day, the President in his best clothes will disappear at the canteen at 9 o'clock while it is raining." And then finally, a very short sa Inquirer, eto na kalagay: "Tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock, the President will disappear." It's a pity we do not see this phenomenon happening every day. Okay, son. Ano yung may moral lesson niya? The moral lesson daw is, one statement can be subjected to various interpretations, depending on our frameworks of understanding. As we understand, so we interpret. Okay, so my topic for today is about understanding. So first of all, we have to realize that knowledge is not the same as understanding. Okay. All of you have a vast store of knowledge. But computers also have knowledge. No? And in fact, mas magaling sila kaysa sa atin. But we're not computers. So what's the difference between knowledge and understanding? Okay, so when you preach, you have to focus on not only allowing your parishioners to know what the gospel is, but to understand. Okay? So knowledge, you know something based on our philosophy. You know something if I know what it is made of, why it was made, and who made it. This is the classic definition of knowledge, which is based on four causes. Material cause, formal cause, final cause, and efficient cause. Okay? And then yeah, it's a philosophy niyo. And because of this, knowledge is all about information, data, or in modern parlance, bytes. Okay, marami tayong mga bytes sa computer. Okay? Now, understanding is different. It is a uniquely human activity that deals primarily, not with information, but with an elusive reality, which we call meaning. Okay. So, iba yung knowledge, iba yung meaning. When you ask, for instance, you want to know, you ask, what is it? Okay? But when you want to understand, you ask, what do you mean? What does this mean? Okay? So, meaning. It's very important. That's why Jesus in Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, who do people say that I am? And when they said, according to survey, 70% said you are Elijah, Isaiah, one of the prophets. Another percentage said that you are John the Baptist. Now, about you, who do you say that I am? Why did he ask that question? He asked that question wherever in Caesarea Philippi, one of the biggest cities of the old Roman Empire, where they had the statues of their gods and goddesses. No? Nariyan sila Athena, sila Apollo, Venus, and Jesus was standing there, so small compared to these gods. And he asked them, who do you say that I am? Okay? Yung bang question niya eh, do you know who I am? Do you know me? Hindi, ang pwede niyang malaman is the answer of this to this question. What do I mean to you? Okay? Which is very important. What do I mean to you? Because if I don't mean anything to you right now, how can you say you love me? Okay? So, what do I mean to you? Very important. Even among your friends or among your loved ones, have you ever asked them, do I mean anything? So, yeah, what does Jesus mean to me? Okay? You know, one time we had a retreat like this, and our retreat master asked us, who is your God? Who is your God? So, syempre, mga Dominicans yan, pretending to be very intelligent. So, he said, Jesus is our God. Sabi niya sa amin, liars! Liars! No, gusto niya mag-win. Mag-walk out, lalo na ng kanong lawyers. Gusto mag-walk out. Kasi, tinawag naming liars eh, ang aming motto, veritas, no? Truth. Liars! So, gusto na namin umalis, pero sabi niya, let me explain. You say, Jesus is your God. But, remember this, sabi niya. Ayan, Jesus is my God. But, sabi niya, whoever controls you is your God. So don't say Jesus is your God if you allow so many things, if you allow so many emotions that you have, if you allow fear to control you, if you allow ambition to control you, if you allow your cell phones to control you, no? If you say, I cannot live without my cell phone, then your cell phone is your God, okay? Because it controls you. So we have to ask ourselves, if Jesus really is my God, he means that to me, then I must allow him to control my life. Okay? So, also we ask ourselves, what does priesthood mean to me? I know that I am a priest. What does this mean to me today? Okay? This is very important. Why? Because the most basic problem in the priesthood for me, it's not primarily about sex scandals, the lack of vocation, clerical obedience, involvement in politics, financial mismanagement. Hindi yan ang problema, basic problem ng priesthood. Because all of these problems are derived from something. And what is it? It has got to do with our self-understanding and how we respond to the demands of our vocation according to such self-understanding. Because if you understand your priesthood wrongly, then your action will also be proceeding from that wrong understanding. Remember, sabi na, agere, sanctur, esse. Okay? So, if your understanding of your being a priest is a mistake, then all your activities will also be mistaken. Okay? So, priest self-understanding, napaka-importante niya. How do you understand yourself as priest? Because if you do not understand well, you're being a priest, chances are, you're doing your functions wrongly. Ganun din yung lady, okay? Nung year of the lady, tinanong ko nga minsan when I was talking about the lady, to know how they understand the lady. Sabi ko sa mga parishioners ng USB na nag-attend ng seminar on the lady, sabi ko sa inyo, sino sa inyo ang talagang lady? Who are you are from? Sisters, priesthood, lady. May katulong taas ng naman. Kami po taga-lady. Wala sa inyong Bisaya dito.
No offense.
Meron kaming sekretary talaga. Ganyan ang pronunciation niya. No? So, sabi niya, si Sel, sabi ko, kung magpunta kayo sa USD, hanapin niyo si Sel, siya ang sekretary ng Public Affairs Office. No? Si Sel. Minsan tinanong, anong pangalan mo, Sel? Sabi ko, Baselia. Pala ko si Silvia, no? Sabi nung boss nila, si Giovanna, parang mas grabe yung asawa niya. Sabi ko, anong pangalan ng asawa mo? Jun. Ano yung junior? Hindi po, Jun na lang. Grabe, no? Isa lang yung pare si Father. Sino rin yung kaklase si Father Papa? Wala. Si Father Papa, isa sa pinakabuha mo namin pare. Father Patricio Amin Papa. Ang initial niyang Papa. So yung kanyang pamagiging sumali sa iba-ibang contest, sa beauty contest. Kasi yung bilib niya maganda siya, no? Sa baby. And then finally, lahat talo siya, sumali na lang siya doon sa Miss Lake Landing. No? Nung celebration, nung landing ni MacArthur sa LinkedIn. So, si MacArthur. So, nakasali naman siya. Nakarating siya sa semi-final. Suli man na lang sila. Tinanong daw siya. Okay, this is the most crucial question. Pare-pare ang question niyo. Siya yung una-una. So, makaposing ko siya. Sabi raw. Okay, tell us, what is your edge over all these candidates? No? Sabi raw. My edge. Ganun niya yung kanyang talent scout. Anong edge? Sabi niya raw, edad. Activity should be in the government, in the family, in society. as 11 of these places. Ang gusto lang nila, nakikita sila nasa altar. Which I think not correct. Okay? So, the self-understanding also of many Catholic lay people today, you hear them say, let us read together, I am a Catholic because I believe in God and I try my best to do good and avoid evil. I don't need to follow everything that the church tells me. I am sure God is with me even if I seldom go to church. Yeah, usually, ang naririnig natin sinasabi na kaya. Despite the church's position on birth control, on contraception, sige pa rin sila. Because ang what they say, as long as I believe in God and I try to do good and avoid evil. So ano yung self-understanding nila? For them, believing is more important than belonging. Okay? See? Parang tingin nila sa simbahan, parang social club lang. No? They join if they like. If they don't like what is being taught there, they disappear. But in fact, for us, believing should be the basis of our belonging. Okay? So, the quest for understanding is very important because it leads us, sabi nga kahapon ni Father Michael, we need to understand what is going on inside us and between us so that from this understanding we can arrive at understanding, disagreement to agreement, confusion to certainty, indifference to commitment, division to unity. Kaya napaka-importante itong task to understand. Okay? Dapat yan ang lagi nyo ipo-focus every time you have a gathering to try to understand one another. Okay? So, yeah, what is, those of you naman, information, okay? Classic. What is a classic? It's defined as anything that is timeless because it is forever timely. Kaya rin yung mga classic movies, no matter how many times you watch them, or no matter what generation watches them, it always appeals to every generation. See, tulad ng Sound of Music, yan eh, 23 times kung pinanood. No? Casablanca, mga 15 times kung pinanood yan. No? 10 Commandments, siguro mga 40 na lang. So, ano ba ang mga classic? Himala. No? That's a classic. So, whenever you watch it, it is timeless. So, walang generation na pinag-over siya. Every generation likes it because the message is timeless. You can always relate to it. So, what is classic priestly formation? Okay. What is classic priestly formation? So, you mga rectors dito ng seminary. So, it is helping seminarians develop the ability to think and decide for themselves, to correctly understand themselves and the meaning of events in the life of faith, and how to wisely order their lives according to a proper hierarchy of values. I think for me, this is classic formation. Knowledge, understanding, and then wisdom. Okay? But of course, the link from knowledge to wisdom is understanding. And even Jesus emphasized this. Kasi sa Deuteronomy, basahin natin, you shall love the Lord your God with your whole heart, with your whole soul, with your whole strength. Binago ni Jesus yan. Sabi niya, basahin natin, you shall love the Lord your God with your whole heart, with your whole soul, with your whole mind. Okay? So bakit ganun? Kasi nga, ang focus niya is yung classic for you to be able to know, understand, and to be wise. Because you cannot love that which you do not understand. Okay? So, katulad dito, the importance of wisdom. May nahulog na kahoy mula sa langit. tinawag ng leader ng lahat ng tao to discuss what to do with the piece of
parang sa voting.
Sa bago pumakit kami sa altar, nag-procession, doon ako kumestro sa malapit na doon sa celebrant para makikita ko kung ano yung ginagawa niya. So pagkakit daw sa altar, ayan, nakikita niya. Lahat ng mga Belgian priests, nakasama niya, Dominicans pala, humahalik sa altar. O gano'n. Patahilin, no? Hindi na mahalikan yung altar straight. Kasi magbudunggul ng ilong nila, no? Kaya sabi niya, yung pala ang purpose kung bakit ako tinawag. Sa loob siya nalaw, tuloy-tuloy siya ngayon. Walang sagawa. Kaya sabi niya sa amin, kaya kayo, don't feel inferior kapag yung ilong niyo ay nakiswat lang sa mukha ninyo. Kasi nabukas ang bench yan. Tingnan niyo sa mga sini, yung mga Amerikano, pag nagkahalikan, pag ganun-ganun sila. Samantalang tayo, strict. Masyado siyang fixated dun sa the fact na hindi siya marunong ng French, no? Kasi French. May kwento na ganyan sa inyo? Ay, di ba? Okay, so sabi niya na, every day, the Belgian priest were telling, hola, Enrico, no? Kumandalugu, no? Saba, kumandalugu, no? So, kumandalugu lang ang kumandalugu. How are you lang naman ang ibig sabihin? How are you? So, kung sumanis sa kumandalugu, so sabi niya, siguro dapat lang yan doon ng sense of humor, no? So, next time, pinig ko naman siya ng prior. Hola, Enrico! Temadalibu! Sabi niya, Temadu! What's Temadu? Mabuti! Celebrated his 50th anniversary as a priest in 1999. Father Pedro Tratenia from Catanduanes. No? And then, si Father Pedro Tratenia, during the feast day and during his 50th anniversary, which happened to be on August 8th, he delivered this beautiful sermon. So, inanaw siya to deliver the homily during the feast of St. Dominic. At ito yung comedy niya. Sabi niya, this was 1999. Hanggang ngayon buhay pa siya. Sabi niya, I am now 80 years old and 50 years as a priest. Many of you will consider me as already old. But I consider myself not old nor young, but a person who is worth a fortune. I am worth a fortune because when I look at myself in the mirror, I feel like a living deposit of natural resources. I have silver in my hair, gold in my teeth, stones in my kidney, lead in my bones, and gas in my stomach. If I sell everything that I have in my body, I will indeed be worth a fortune. Oh, kita niyo? Yan ang tinatawag na right sense of perspective. Pero in-explain din yan, ang hirap na yung maunawaan. One of his problems is how to understand young people. Sabi niya, 50 years ago, when I was ordained priest, life was very simple. At that time, fast food was what we ate during Lent. Singapabilisan. Sparrows were birds and at the subway steam. Coke was a cold drink. Pot was very cold food. Now, coke and pot are drugs. AIDS were helpers in the convent, not a disease. During our time, we lifted weights and spirits. Now they lift noses, faces, and breasts. Sometimes I am confused when I hear the confessions of young people. In our time, a cardinal sin has to be avoided. Now, cardinal sin must be obeyed. Anyway, so yeah, sense of perspective. The part is not the whole. Yeah. And you have to situate everything within a bigger context. Now, I don't know if you have heard the story of a student in USD who failed in his who failed the last semester of his para mag-graduate na siya, no? Tapos bumagsak siya. At ang course pa niya, medicine. Okay? So, sabi niya, how will I tell my parents? Kaya tuition sa medicine sa USD is around 100,000 na per semester. So, kung kayo yun, paano sasabihin niya? So, umuho siya, tapos yung ulan niya. Okay, pwede itong gayahin.